In line with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals number 3, which targets good health and well-being for all, the Onyebuchi Christi Fedora OCI Foundation held the second edition of their health symposium to promote breast and cervical cancers awareness and prevention. The OCI Foundation is a non-governmental organization established in 2016. As at mid-2018, the organization is now a registered charity body in both Nigeria and Australia to promote the health and educational needs of the youths, which are significant components in human capital development. The OCI Health Symposium, held on Tuesday, 23rd October 2018, at Stella Maris College, Umueri, Anambra State, Nigeria, targeted female SS3 students from all the public secondary schools in Otuocha Educational Zone, Anambra State, Nigeria. Dignitaries in attendance include the First Lady of Anambra State, Chief Mrs. Ebelechukwu Obiano, represented by the Executive Secretary of the State Primary Health Development Agency, community leaders, school teachers, the management of the Post-Primary School Service Commission, PPSSC Headquarters, OCA. Others are government functionaries, a representative of the World Health Organization, WHO, Southeast Zone, and the legal advisor of the OCI Foundation, among others. The principal, Stella Maris College, Umueri, Mrs. Chinwe Agu, in a welcome address, commended the OCI Foundation for enhancing the knowledge of the students and urged the participants to take advantage of the opportunity to better their lives.
The management of this school is proud to associate with the OCI Foundation, the founder, Dr. Chris Ifedora, and his team, and will always provide accommodation anytime it is needed. We appreciate the keen interest OCI Foundation has for the students, both in academics and health issues.
Speaker after speaker at the event poured in communes on the president and founder of the OCI Foundation, Dr. Chris Ifedora, for his huge concern in empowering the children of Otuocha Zone, especially the girl child.
Legal advisor and the friends of Dr. Ifedora, we are happy about your presence here, and we ask you, please send our gratitude to the man in charge of this occasion. There's one disease which we suffer in this our area. I would like in the next year or any time this type of program is organized, you add it. And what is that? What we suffer here, and which is endemic, is early marriage.
I'm so happy that somebody from this zone will come up with such educated proposal. Other zones don't have it. I'm so proud of the country. I see somebody, somewhere, outside this place, is thinking of the children of this particular zone. Please. Any day I get up from my bed, once I pray, I'll say, God bless this man. God should give him the finance to continue with what he's doing. And God should add more years to him. We need more of Ifedora in this soul.
I know that this vice started about 2 years ago. And they have been giving scholarships to our students, even to university level. Currently, I heard that these students are in university under their scholarship. And like I was asking the zonal director, has anyone graduated? Then I remember they just started 2 years. So maybe by the next 4 years, we'll have a graduate on their scholarship. Barrister, please extend our profound gratitude to the founder, Dr. Ifedora. We really appreciate. There is nothing we can give him than to pray that God, who led this in his heart, will continue to uphold it. And as he continues to help these children, he will never lack in life. He will not die prematurely. He will live to fulfill the purpose of his creation on earth in the name of Jesus Christ.
Honestly, I am glad that he sent a thing like this in motion to encourage Anambra students, not only because of the scholarships, but he actually understood the importance of education, you know, educating our girls. And he understood the importance of women, ladies. And I must tell us young children, young ladies in school, that womanhood is a sacred thing. Do you understand? Ladies do not live life like men, right? There's something sacred about being a woman. And Dr. Ifedora, being a man, understood this, and he went into the system of encouraging girls, ladies, especially as regards their health. Now, the future in Anambra, our concern is mothers, children, and ladies. We call them women of childbearing age. And we want to actually recognize what he's doing. He asked us to be here. What I'm going to tell the people seated here is that in no time, WHO, in collaboration with Nigeria, will be introducing something we'll call HPV. We say it's human papilloma vaccine for this cervical cancer. We will introduce that into our what we call routine immunization, hopefully by next year.
It's a laudable project. Not everybody can do it. And I can bet you the way he's going, in the next few years, Anambra State will see where this project is taking our children to. I mean, it's something all of us should be happy and be proud of. So I thank God for him.
The doctor is doing a marvelous job, because we've seen that so many women are dying out of breast cancer and cervical cancer. And when you teach them young, they will be able to identify, because cancer, the problem of cancer is when you identify it early, then you can now take correction. The doctor can heal. But when it becomes too late, no remedy again.
I'm very glad and happy that this particular terminal disease is being tackled from the right stage, because these are young girls from the age of 15, 16, 17, and 18. And earlier, the better. So I'm so happy that this man, Ifedora, is trying to fight against it, that terminal disease, and also to bring home the remedies to it, and also the prevention. For the saying says, the prevention is better than the cure.
The legal advisor, OCI Foundation, Barrister Onyechi Ononye, who represented the foundation's president and founder, Dr. Chris Ifedora, said the health symposium of the OCI Foundation has become an annual event in which young girls will be educated on how to take charge of their health.
The dream that gave birth to this event has taken years to formulate, plan, and finally implement. The dream has always been to find ways to create a society where everyone feels empowered to take control of his or her own health.
Speaking through a video record, the president and founder, OCI Foundation, Dr. Chris Ifedora, said the foundation's health promotion program, designed to help young women identify early symptoms of breast and cervical cancers, will be sustained to reach all those at risk, wherever they may be. He added that with the support of Harvard Medical School, Boston, USA, and the international bodies in Australia and possibly Nigeria, the OCI Foundation plans to introduce breast and cervical cancers awareness campaigns into the academic curricula of senior secondary schools across Nigeria.
So the OCI Foundation have decided to champion ways that will ensure that our health promotion activities are not only sustainable, but will also reach all those who need them, wherever they may be. With the support of the Harvard Medical School, Boston, the United States of America, where Dr. Chris Ifedora, the foundation's president, currently studies, as well as support from other international bodies in Australia and possibly Nigeria, the OCI Foundation has plans to introduce breast and cervical cancer awareness campaigns into the academic curricula of senior secondary schools across Nigeria. We intend to start with schools in Anambra State first, and we'll be approaching the appropriate authorities, some of which are seated here today, to work out the details and modalities. We also intend to engage religious institutions, mosques, churches, and traditional outfits so that we can find interventions that are not only sustainable, but socially and culturally acceptable. Ladies and gentlemen, given the foregoing, we enjoin everyone here and beyond to team up with the OCI Foundation. Together, we can do this. As a matter of fact, all four ministries of the Anambra State Government invited to this event today can help us achieve this purpose, at the state level at least. The NGOs and other bodies here today, as well as those we are yet to reach out to, also have roles to play. The press and media organizations, school teachers, politicians, parents, traditional rulers, and all other stakeholders are also welcome to join this movement, which will be executed under the slogan, the Arm Our Girls Campaign of the OCI Foundation.
Responding, the wife of the state governor, Chief Minister Ebele Chukwu Obiano, represented by the Executive Secretary, Primary Health Development Agency, Anambra State, Dr. Choma Ezeniemolu, praised the OCI Foundation for their consistency in the promotion of breast and cervical cancer's awareness. She observed that early breast cancer detection can be improved by breast self-examination and urged the girls to put into practice the lessons they gather from the symposium.
It's really very good to know that the promise we had last year that it will be a yearly event has been fulfilled. This shows the commitment of OCI Foundation. We really want to thank him, Dr. Chris Ifedion. He has that vision and the mission to cater for the young, especially the girls. So we are really very happy with him. So DML would have been here, but she's unavoidably absent at this time.
In a lecture on breast cancer, a public medicine physician, Dr. Emmanuel Azuike, said the cause of cancer is largely unknown, but begins with an uncontrollable growth of human cells. He noted that cancer can occur in one out of every 8 women of all ages and gave tips on the risk factors, early symptoms, and preventive practices against breast and cervical cancers.
The summary of behind you in Google, most things you get know. Number one, with this breast self-examination, which I can go see in a video now. Number two, those lifestyle things you can change. Increase vegetable, increase exercise, avoid alcohol, avoid smoking. These are the ones you can do.
High point of the symposium was a video documentary film show of how to perform breast self-examination, which the students watched with delight. One of the students, in a vote of thanks, expressed gratitude for the awareness and knowledge they have gained from the lecture.
I wish to seize this podium to express our heartfelt gratitude to God Almighty, who made this day a great day.
Since a healthy society is a wealthy society, the initiative of the OCI Foundation to enhance the capacity of the girl child to take charge of her own health will definitely blossom like a mustard seed that can grow to impact positively on the attitude of women towards the prevention of breast and cervical cancers. Expectations are high that millions of Nigerian young women will benefit from this health program in the next few years. May God continue to bless the OCI Foundation as they rise by blessing others.